Hello guys and welcome to Should I Play This? Today I'm going to take a look at FTL, Faster Than Light. It's a roguelike game and you can get it on iPad as well if you want to play from your couch. It's about piloting a spaceship and seeing how far you can get without dying horribly. So we'll try and do just that. And here we will pick the standard Kestrel. I'm by no means an expert at this game, but I have a grasp of the basics, so I play it on normal, and let's go. The data you carry is vital to the remaining Federation fleet. You'll need supplies for the journey, so make sure you explore each sector before moving on to the next. But get to the exit before the pursuing rebel fleet can catch up. So we are escaping from the rebel fleet, and if it catches up, we'll probably die horribly. Tip, targets, prioritize your targeting and combat. Weapons and shields are usually the best choice, but if they're fleeing, hit the engines or piloting to prevent escape. Alright, so let's get going. So this is our spaceship here. And you'll just have to imagine that you're Captain Picard on the Enterprise, or Han Solo on the Millennium Falcon, if you're so inclined. So maybe this could be Chewbacca. It's actually Lang, is his name. Can we rename him? No, I don't think so. Anyway, that's Lang. He's a pilot, and here in the missiles room, we have Kosar, and here we have Ferry, and he's manning the engines. And as you can see up here, we have some evade and we have some oxygen. And the oxygen is these little guys need oxygen in order to survive. So if we lose oxygen in the spaceship, we have to get it back quick, or they will die. And evade is a chance to evade enemy fire. Let's try and move this little guy down here. And then you can see I took him off the engines and my evade dropped by 5%. So we'll put him back on. If I move this little guy in here, he's away from the console. He's not manning the helm of the ship. And our evade is now 0, which is turns it red. So that warns you not to do that at all times. And if I open these little doors here, then the oxygen leaves the ship, and nobody really has any reason to go in here, so we just leave them open. Because we might get boarded by an enemy ship or something like that, and Chewbacca might get killed, and we don't want that. So let's get ready to roll. Let's try going to an unvisited location, see what's there. Your scans reveal an ore refinery and several factories, all standing still and empty, no life signs detected. So there's nothing of interest here. That's okay. We'll just move to the next. Here's a store, but I don't think we have picked up a lot of these resources to buy stuff for yet, so we should probably try and go here instead, an unvisited location. So as you can see, an event comes each time we go to a node. Oh no, here we are getting attacked by a rebel hostile ship. You arrive in an asteroid belt to discover that a rebel automated scout has been stationed here. Prepare for a fight. Well, we'll prepare, and we press spacebar to pause the game, and then you can issue all of your commands and what you're going to do and plan for the battle, and then when you press spacebar it'll go back to real time again. So we should do something here. We'll put some energy into our lasers and we will fire a missile. And as you can see here, we can choose to fire it at the shields or at the helm or at the engine or at the missiles and weapons. So let's try and hit the shields, bring them down. Maybe I'll shoot the laser at the weapons. Maybe we can disable them so I can't shoot back. Here we go. Took out both of my turrets and my laser. And we missed. Do the same again. So I think that his shields are taken down for now. And I don't think we need to necessarily fire more lasers at him. Maybe we should hit the engine so we can't escape. He just fired at me, he hit here and here. And now I kill them. Oh no, there's a fire. The ship explodes, leaving behind a substantial collection of useless scrap metal. Scrap metal. Yeah, that's great. 17 of these little things here, and one missile, and 3 of these molecules. I guess we can buy some stuff with that. So now we need to put out this fire. I think we might move him in here, maybe he'll do it. Apparently not so much. Move him up here, and then the O2 to clean that up. Then we'll open this door here, and this door here. We need to get this guy out of here. Now I opened up all the doors here, so that I can get the oxygen to leave the room, so then that'll take care of the fire. It can't breathe and it'll die. I repaired the O2 as well. And we have another fire, it's because we're moving through our asteroid field. I guess I just need to jump out here somehow, but I can't because this is also red. So taking a lot of damage here. From hitting asteroids. So now we can jump. Because the helm is repaired. Let's go to the store to see what that is all about. A ship engineer has set up a small store here. Alright. Crew teleporter allows you to send your crew members to board enemy vessels. That might be useful. Drone control powers the ship's drone. Purchase comes with free defense drone Mark 1. Well, I can't afford this. I can't afford this either. I only have 27 scrap metal, I guess. So, refiner and fuel. One jump per fuel. So I can do 16 jumps and we have 7 missiles. Well, let's repair my ship. I think we just need to move on. We should get this guy back on the engines again. Like so. He's hurt, he'll go to the med bay. Now he's healed up, I'll go back here and fix this weapons room. Need to fix the shields as well. Send him to fix it. And then when I have fixed the shields, we are ready to jump. It's just working away. Let's just go now, actually. Oh, here we can see that here's the rebel fleet. So I have to jump further away from them. If they catch up with me, it's game over. And the exit is over here, so let's go here. A mercenary hails you. Greetings, friend. We've heard tell of your quest and are here to offer you our valuable services. Alright, I can't afford to hire them. It doesn't really look like I want to fight this thing. So, let's tell him we have no need of his services. And continue fixing our shields. Now they are fixed. So let's jump out of here. I think we should head towards the exit, just to be on the safe side. The scans reveal a mining base on a nearby planet long since abandoned, no life signs detected. Nothing here. Actually, Ferry and Lang is not doing too great. Maybe they should just quickly go in here and get rid of their influencer. So now all my little friends here are back up to full health and we'll jump on. Maybe I should try and, I don't know, I think I need some more fuel probably at some point. But let's go here first and then we'll head to the store afterwards if I find some more scrap. The sensors have picked up a refugee ship drifting through the system, no doubt one of many fleeing the rebel advance. It doesn't appear to have detected you, or else it is trying to avoid notice. Refugees, let's hail them. As you hail the refugee ship, a pirate ship jumps into the system. It was using the refugee ship as bait. That's just mean. Let's pause the game a little bit. We'll figure out what to do. So this is a pirate interceptor. I think I'll try to hit. Maybe I can power the weapons a little bit more. And then I will fire my missile at the shield and the burst laser at the weapons. And resume the game. We'll see what happens. Are you ready to fire? There goes the missile. It hits for 2 points. There goes the burst laser. It also hits. So let's see what else we can do here. Everything's fine. So we fire another missile. Maybe now both the shields and the guns of the enemy ship is out, so I guess I'll stop firing the missiles because I don't have that many. I have 5. So I'll take it out with the. There we go. The laser. The pirate ship breaks apart and you salvage what you can. And we've got 17 scrap metal, a drone part, and some fuel. So that's great. The refugee ship thanks you for your assistance. As a gesture of goodwill and seeing how effectively you dispatch the enemy ship, they offer up what supplies they can spare. That's great. Thank you, refugees. And we'll jump on. So now I have 35 scrap metal, but it's still really not a lot. So I guess I'll go to this distress beacon instead of this door. Once you arrive at the location of the distress call, a civilian ship hails you. Thanks for responding to our beacon. Our FTL navigation has gone haywire and we can't plot a course to the nearest depot to get it fixed. Could you lead us there? Yeah, sure, why not? Class Federation Scout, Federation ship neutral. Let's lead them to their destination. Take this bit of scrap as a down payment. We'll use your jump signatures to follow. You're really helping us out here. Add a crystal marker to your map. Alright, so now we have a quest and we got a little bit of scrap. Maybe we should. I was wondering if I can see. I can see how good he is at stuff here. So Lang is best at the helm actually. And Ferry is okay at the helm and engines. So I guess they work up experience when they man the system. So that's fine, we'll keep it like this. We have new places to go. Here's the quest, so we have to go there. Now we can actually go past the store, and then we can go to the quest, and then we can exit. Let's go to the store first. There's only one other ship at this beacon that is showing heavy damage. You receive a message on your console. Greetings, traveler. We were crippled by a band of pirates and are now forced to sell our remaining valuable equipment to acquire the necessary supplies to get home. Okay. So, what do we have here? We can buy one more crew member. No, we can't. We're missing 2 scrap metal for that. So, actually can't really buy much of anything. Automated reloader. Cooldown between weapon shots is improved by 10%. That's the only thing I can afford. I don't know if that is all that helpful. I think we'll just hang on to our scrap metal for now. Yeah, let's do that. Let's keep on moving. Go to the quest marker, see what's up. There we go. The ship you were escorting thanks you. I don't think we could have made it without your help. Let my friends patch you up some of your hull and show you their wares. So this is it's another shop. Well, that doesn't help much. I still don't have any money. Nah, I can't really buy anything. Well, let's move on. I think it's time to. Can we make one more jump? I think we have to go to the exit. Let's go to the exit and see what's there. you have arrived at the long range beacon. When the FTL drive is charged, you can jump to the next sector. An advanced Rebel automated ship remains stationed near a small Rebel space station. Sensors indicate it's a storage vessel for military goods. Alright. Should we attack this to get the storage cache? Should we move on? I can't see what systems it has. I think we'll attack it and see what happens. Let's pause. So we need some missiles to hit something. I think that I should try and disable its weapons and its shields like this. Let's see how that goes. So here's the FTL drive, apparently it's charging up and I can jump when it's charged up. So I think I took out both his weapon and shields, so, and it doesn't have more than 3 hull and 1 shield, so yeah, I guess we'll be okay. Let's see. Come on, little Chewbacca. Make our weapons work again. We have our burst laser back. There we go, firing. Oh, it's a miss. Here comes the burst laser, that's a miss as well. I only have one missile left. Ah, there we go. I hope it had some missiles in that storage cache. It didn't, it only had 15 scrap. The station was either abandoned or stripped clean. It seems to have lain unused for quite some time. You find nothing useful, so that was really not... it was really not a fantastic thing for us. So now we are in the next sector. Now I have to press the button, next sector. Here we are. So now I can choose between Sultan or civilian sector. I think we'll go to the civilian sector and see what's that about. Welcome to a new sector. Get to the exit beacon and jump to the next sector before the Sultan can catch you. Yeah. We'll do that. So let's go to the first node. Maybe we should head up here. I could go here. I might want to double back to the store, so I can go here, here, and there. Or maybe the rebels will come, so I don't have time for the store, but we'll see. Upon completing your jump, you receive a message from a nearby ship. Greetings and welcome to a beacon. For a small fee, we'll let you continue on your way. They want 25 of my scrap and it took me forever to get it. So we're not paying any kind of toll. Pirate Interceptor, we've beaten that before in this game. We will reject the generous offer. Too bad you'll regret this decision, they say. Alright, so let's power up the weapons. I only have one missile. So we should make it count. Let's hit the weapons and then let's hit the shield. And I'll resume the game and let's see if we can hit anything. Here we go with the missile. That hits for 2 points and the laser hit as well. So now both the shields and weapon system is down. But I'm down to only the laser now. Took away 2 hull, so we have 3 left. Waiting for the burst laser to recharge. Here we go again. The enemy ship appears to be powering up its FTL, trying to escape. I don't think they have time to escape. No, they don't. Here we go. So they left us 19 scrap, 1 drone part and 2 fuel. That's not too bad. So let's move on. I could double back to the store and buy some missiles. I think I'll do that because I don't feel confident about doing combat without missiles. The space station here has a traveling merchant who shows you his wares. Let's take a look at that. So here they have a couple of drones, but I guess I'll have to get a drone control module in order to use them. I don't really have that. I think I'll buy some missiles. And this store had 3 missiles that I could buy. I might also pick up some fuel, just a couple. And then we need to fix our hull. Yeah, and we could buy this bomb, small bomb. Self-teleporting explosives that damages systems and crew, but not the hull, can target your own ship. I think I'll skip that. Let's jump on. We've already been there, so let's go here. Unvisited location. You find a space station set up for travelers. Browsing through its listings, you find a tavern full of mercenaries for hire. You look for potential crew members. Alright, so I can hire this guy, which I just did because he looks badass. Ferris. I think he can hit some people in the head if they board my ship. Let's put him on shields. That's your station now, Ferris. Let's jump on. You barely have time to register jump completion before your ship warns you of an incoming ship with weapons hot. So we're going to have to fight. And this is a pirate scout and it's hostile. So let's power back up our missiles. And let's fire at the shields with the laser, and the missiles will fire the weapon systems. So we're just waiting for our missiles and burst laser to fire. When it charges up, here we go. It seems that we hit the shields at least, so the shields are down. Now we have 6 hull points left. Engines are critical, but we already have Kosa on it, and he can put our rate is down to 0. I think I will move Ferris from shields down to the engine room, so he can help repairing the engine and get some evade back. Well, never mind, we won the battle. The ship explodes, leaving behind a substantial collection of useful scrap material. Yeah, we got 19 scrap, that's pretty good. So move first back on shields. So now we are out of missiles again. I hope you find some more before we have to fight again. Let's continue jumping. There's a store up here, I can buy more missiles. Let's see what they have. At least they have some missiles. And then we have a scrap, so we have to move on. Upon completing your jump, you receive a message from a nearby ship. Greetings and welcome to our beacon. For a small fee, we'll let you continue on your way. We don't even have the money they want. We're going to have to fight this pirate scout. So I have missiles, but maybe I should try and kill it without spending missiles, because the pirate scout is probably not such a big threat. So let's try and see if we can take out the shield first. So my shields were down when they came back up. So now we should hit their shields, because I already took out their weapons. I guess it cost some scrap to repair them as well, so it might be better off firing a missile. Now their weapons are back up. I'll change my mind, I'll fire one missile at their weapons. So now he only has one bullet point left, but he has his healer. There we go. 20 scrap, that's pretty good. Of course we have some hull damage we need to repair now, and we have to repair the helm. We have to repair the doors up here. I guess we can make the jump without being fully repaired. We'll move on. If I go to the store, that should be okay. You come across a rebel automated scout ship pursuing a civilian ship, weapons engaged. Yeah, we should aid the civilian ship. This is an auto assault hostile ship. You power up your weapons. Yeah, so is that an enemy drone? Yeah, that's an enemy combat drone. Repeatedly attacks your ship, can be shut down by damaging the enemy's drone system. Alright, so we should fire some missiles at the drone system. I think I'll also fire at the shield. I hope we can take it out. We can't take it out that quick, there's a lot of points. So maybe we should fire at the weapon system. So hopefully we won't take as much damage. That little drone is annoying, it's taking down my shields a lot of the time. Now I disabled the drone system, so this drone doesn't work right now. I think I'll save the missiles and just keep shooting at their shields with my burst laser. Now his shields are back up. All the while, you can see after my FTL drive is charging up, so I can escape if necessary, but it's not going to be necessary. He's at two hull points now. One more hit and he will die. There we go. That netted us 14 scrap and a drone part and a fuel. The civilian ship wisely made a fast retreat while you distracted the hostile ship. Yeah. They might have stayed behind and given us some supplies for the help. That would have been nice of them, but they didn't. So I think we should try and go as far away from the rebel pursuing fleet as we can. Your sensors have picked up a refugee ship drifting through the system, no doubt one of many fleeing the rebel advance. It doesn't appear to have detected you, or else it is trying to avoid notice. Let's hail them. The vessel is relieved to hear from you. They are running low on supplies. They suggest a trade. So they offer 7 fuel for 1 drone part. That sounds good enough for me. I need the fuel. We will do the trade and we will jump on. Scans reveal a large asteroid field nearby. Short range scanners may discover useful materials while we wait for the FTL to recharge. Well, we already flew through one asteroid field, and I remember that we took some damage while we were there. And with this event here, I guess that either I'll find something and be undamaged, or I'll take damage and find nothing. I think we'll explore it anyway. You know, we are explorers. We are on the verge of the universe, let's check it out. You happen upon an abandoned mining site. A few mining drones were left behind and could be repurposed. So we found 17 scrap and 1 drone part, and we didn't get damaged. Perfect. Let's jump on. I need to head to the exit. So let's go here. So we can go there, or maybe even directly. No, probably not directly, but at least here and here. I guess it should be okay. Stumble across a forward scout of the rebel fleet. They're powering up the FTL. If they get away, they will no doubt warn the fleet of your position. Alright, so we need to make sure that this rebel rigger doesn't get away from us. So we need our trusty missile. We only have one missile. That's not good. We'll aim it at the engines, and we will aim the laser. No, actually, yeah, we'll aim the laser there as well, I guess. So let's see if we can disable the engines. And my weapons are powering up. Here comes the missile. It misses, at least we hit with the burst laser. So they have a defense drone here. Maybe that one took care of my missile. So we're just exchanging fire here. I took down his shields, but they're back up. He only has 5 hull left, so he should be okay. Ah, crap, he jumped out. The scout jumps away. They are sure to have informed the fleet of your position. You must get to the next sector as soon as possible. Fleet pursuit doubled for one jump. Does not sound good because they're already close to me. I might not make it because the exit is down here. I think that maybe I die next turn, or maybe I can make the jump. We'll see. Oh crap. Rebel fleet has found you and a nearby scout turns to engage. The cruisers in the distance are firing on you. This does not sound good. So elite fighter relationship hostile. Oh, it's the Empire. They have found us. So what to do? I guess we have to try and take out the weapons, so maybe I can charge up the FTL drone and I can escape. He's shooting some pretty big balls of fire at me. He has 2 shields, so I'm not really going to take out his weapons. Oh, a warning hull at 75%. And the FTL drive is not even close to powered up. They're firing all kinds of ammunition and rockets and stuff at me. We might just make it, we're almost charged up. Oh no. And the day is down. Engines are not looking too great. Maybe I should move Lang to the engines, because we need the engines to jump out in a little bit. I think I'll move first. I should go here and repair the O2. Almost ready to jump out. Come on, little FTL guy. There we go. Jumping away. But I can't get to the exit. I have to go through this place first. The rebels have control, very dangerous. I couldn't jump down there, so I'm pretty much in big trouble here. Rebel fleet has found you and a nearby scout. Yeah, exactly. So we're charging up the FTL drive again. This is going bonkers. I'm moving back to do the med bay. But this looks like it's going to be the end of this. Because these elite fighters are no joke. So I made a mistake. Oh no, he died. A little co-star died. And we are going to die. Oh, the hull is down. Yeah, I should never have gone up north on the map when I knew the exit was down south and the rebel fleet was approaching too fast. We were just minding our own business, singing a space song, not paying attention. And I've got little Chewbacca and everybody else on the crew killed. We are almost there actually. We only need this part of the FTL drive. Okay, we do work. Yeah, so that's not how you play FTL. Or maybe it is. It's a roguelike, you're supposed to die, and often you die. But it's a lot of fun, and you should try it out yourself if you like Det lukker fedt on your gameplay. One last explosion marks your fate as your ship is torn apart. Score 668, which is a new high score for me. So, thank you for watching.